Hi, this is Beata with Spellbinders Savvy Saturday video. Today I want to show you how to create a card with the spectacular spin cut fold and tuck die. I also used the largest circle of the Splendid Circles as a base, the tag from Home Sweet Home for my sentiment, and for the card base I used the Grand Label 1 dies. The pattern paper is from Bull Bunny's Country Garden selection, and the sentiment is from Just Right Stamper's Vintage Rose Medallion. To begin with, you'll need to cut and emboss your pieces. And I love that the Grand Caliber is so big that you can add several dies and cut several dies at once. You just place them on there, and if you're afraid that the paper might move, just use some repositionable scotch tape to hold it in place while you run it through. And all these are dies I'm using, but I'm using a big piece of cardstock and I know I can squeeze another one in. And when I do that, I usually add some small tag dies that I use a lot in for my projects, and then just put them in an extra bin. And when I create a project, most of the time I already have a tag for my sentiment. Then you just place the paper over it, put the cutting plate on top of that and run it through, and then emboss it by taking the cutting plate off, adding your tan mat and your embossing plate. Once that is done, your pieces will look like this. Now you could leave them in the die and sponge some color over it, and then they would look like this. They look completely different. Well, I already folded it, but you can achieve a completely different look by adding just a little bit of color with your sponge. Or you can also use pattern paper or vellum for a very subtle flower or layered look. So there are lots of different ways you can use this die. Once it comes out, you will take either your fingernail and fold the small piece here over, or you can also, if you have really short fingernails, you can use your paper piercer and just keep on folding and then tucking the piece that you fold over under the next piece that you have exposed here when you folded the last piece over. So you just go around a circle and keep on folding your pieces over and then tucking them under the piece that is right there. And once you're done, your single pieces look like this. And I added a little bit of dimensional adhesive to stack my flower together, or my wheel or whatever. And then to finish it off for my sample, I used 1-2 scrap sleek rhinestone strips. Now, then I added the flower onto the largest piece, the largest circle of Splendid Circles, so just so it has another base and another layer. When I cut shaped card bases, what I do is I cut a single piece of cardstock with the die that I want to use. That will be my card front. Then I fold a piece of paper in half and place it into the die so that the hinge is not cut completely, otherwise you would have two pieces and not a card base, and emboss it. And then when you open it up, you still have this, but you have this hinge. That's where the single piece comes in. You tape that on top of it, and then you have a card base shaped like label one without that hinge showing. I have already cut my pattern paper and sanded it to reveal my embossed edge. I love to do that. But because the labels The grand labels only come in a quarter inch difference. So the next layer is a quarter inch bigger than the first one. I wanted it to have a layer in between. And to do that, you just use the die that you have already used for the paper. And you can see the cutting edge is an eighth of an inch smaller than the edge of your die. So then you just take your die, place it on a piece of cardstock, and trace around it with a pencil, and then use a scissor to cut around it to get that extra layer in between the die sizes. Easy peasy, right? And then you just adhere everything together and create your card. I hope you play with these cut, fold, tuck dies. They're fun and they give a very unique look to your cards, or I can see it beautifully as a gift topper or a box topper. I think the possibilities are endless. See you next time.